Hello friends, so in this video I am going to discuss throttling process in which Joule Thomson coefficient and also its significance. Let us consider a pipe with constricted passage and it will have section 1-1 and 1-2-2. Section 1-1 is inlet and 2-2 is exit. When fluid flows through constricted passage or a partially opened valve or through a porous plug, the flow is throttled, and the steady flow energy equation can be written as H1 plus V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus DQ divided by DM equal to H2 plus V2 square divided by 2 plus GZ2 plus DWX divided by DM. Since there is no shaft, this term becomes zero and there will not be heat transfer also, and there will be negligible potential energy, and the equation reduces to H1 plus V1 square divided by 2 equal to H2 plus V2 square divided by 2. In throttling, the flow velocities are very less and the kinetic energy is negligible. So this becomes also 0. Then the equation reduces to H1 equal to H2. It is nothing but enthalpy before throttling is equal to enthalpy after throttling. During throttling process, there will be a large drop in the temperature of the fluid, and this is the basis for operation of refrigeration and air conditioning. And this may not be the case always. Sometimes the temperature remains constant and the temperature may increase, and the behavior of the temperature during the throttling process can be described with the help of a Joule-Thomson coefficient. Joule-Thomson coefficient, that Joule-Thomson coefficient is given by mu, that is equal to dou T divided by dou P at constant enthalpy. Here Joule-Thomson coefficient is the ratio of change in temperature with pressure at a constant enthalpy, and Joule-Thomson coefficient, there may be three conditions, which are the first case is mu less than 0, mu equal to 0, and mu greater than 0. When mu is less than 0, the temperature increases when mu equal to 0, temperature remains constant. When mu is greater than 0, temperature decreases during a constant enthalpy process, that is throttling.